it's a blessing and it's a freedom to be able to start my day like this. The beauty of having my studio on the beach is that I get to walk towards my inspiration. And if you look at shells on the beach, you look at the sky, you look at the horizon, it can give you a palette for the day.
Temptation, I can't resist.
At the water's edge, temptation and inspiration beckon artist Gale Fulton Ross.
Sometimes I actually collect the shells and the colors that I think I want to try to duplicate. The funny thing is, though, you get them into the studio, colors are gone. Colors are gone. It's as if once you've removed them from where they began, it ends.
Where they began, the nature that surrounds her, inspires her.
I have been infused and influenced by this world, this earth, this picture that I have been provided naturally to begin my work.
Gale's artwork is a sampler of artistic influences, and she likes it that way.
I consider myself a bilingual artist. Bilingual in the fact that I speak both languages. Art is a language. I speak the abstract language and I can speak the figurative language.
Often her contrasting styles peacefully coexist on one canvas, each one containing autobiographical undertones.
Now, gonna get it now.
Her hands have brushed the faces of powerful leaders that painted modern history.
I have had the marvelous opportunity to paint some of the most well-known people, and I'm always in awe, and I am always hard-pressed to not feel like a fan when I do it, but it's my job, and I enjoy it.
This is the beginning of an abstract self-portrait. And it's profile. And it's only supposed to envelop the textures I feel.
Gale's real life portrait is as colorful as the one on canvas. She grew up in Malden, Massachusetts, a lower middle class suburb of Boston.
My father and mother were both hardworking people. He was a body and fender man for a company called Ferry Street Motors.
Herman Fulton was a natural draftsman and a self-taught artist. He was also Gale's greatest artistic influence.
From the time I was a little girl, I remember somebody, him introducing his children, he had three daughters. And he said, and that's my baby artist. It was written in stone. Never wanted to be another thing.
Gale attended an art comprehensive high school. Her budding talents earned her a college scholarship.
I also got pregnant, lost that scholarship, still promised I would go to school.
A promise she kept while raising her proudest creation, her son, Craig Ross, Jr.
Ooh, child, things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter.
Gale chose to learn the business side of art, receiving bachelor's and master's degrees in the study of museums.
And my hope was to be a curator, but a curator needs a PhD. All I wanted to do was paint.
And paint she did, all over the world.
My actual lessons in art come from other artists, Parisian artists, an Asian artist, a Peruvian artist. All of these artists make up who I am.
Gale came to Sarasota in 1990 when a local art dealer discovered her work in New York.
I was the first black artist to show in Sarasota, downtown, on Palm.
She fell in love with the Gulf Coast, settling here in 1994.
And what I was trying to do is the color, they would complement each other because
right.
I tried to do them as a couple.
Right.
Gallery owner Alan Gallup has been a fan and friend ever since.
I feel the same way about her today as I did then. That is to say, she's warm and very generous person, aside from her creativity.
My whole body of work is one big painting.
Introspective and outspoken, the bilingual artist refuses to stay inside the lines, something her father was unable to do.
In my 30s, he took his life and committed suicide because he was a perfectionist in a very imperfect world.
Which makes Gale's successes that much more meaningful.
Everything I do is a tribute to what he gave me, because I think that you never die. Your body goes away, your spirit's there. And so every one of my successes is his success. And nobody can take that away. And that's why I do what I do.
Perhaps that's why at age 61, Gale is a blur in perpetual motion. The paint on her living canvas never dry.
The fun of them, fun of working, is nobody's telling me whether it's finished or it's not. Just me. So I'm my boss and I'm my worst critic. But as you can see, I'm very blessed. I am sitting here playing like a child, making a living.
Temptation. Blessed with fond memories and nature's influences, the colors of Gale Fulton Ross will never fade.